welcome you all with my love and respects. Continuously in all of us, life is happening. That is why our body is moving. Still we are able to feel we are alive. By its very nature, life is bliss. By its very nature, life is bliss. So whether you want it or not, you accept it or not, you realize it or not, life by its very nature is bliss. See, Sanskrit, there is a proverb. Two enlightened masters don't utter the same thing or don't express the same concept. There is a clear instruction. If two masters are talking the same words, someone is fake. Because when a person gets enlightened, he always expresses himself uniquely as an unique individual. So no two masters will speak the same thing or same way. There's a big conflict now. For example, if you go and ask about food, how to eat, what to eat. If you ask Mahavira, he will say, don't eat, fast unto death. If you ask Buddha, he will say, no. Once a day you can eat, that's all right. If you are sick, maybe little more, twice a day. If you ask Krishna, eat whatever, just forget that you ate. Same about marriage. If you ask Mahavira, he will say no. If you ask Buddha, he will say, even if you are already married, escape. If you ask Krishna, just forget the number. Each one will express their own way as they experienced, as their unique expression. On each concept, when you ask, each one will express the truth in a different way. But all masters happened on the planet Earth. All saints, sages, avatars, all of them agree on one point. There is no variation. That one point is, by nature, human beings are bliss. Please understand, if all masters are agreeing, nobody has a second opinion, nobody has a different opinion, means naturally this is something basic, vital point. That is why I built this whole program on this vital point. All over the world, in all cultures and all traditions, all sages, saints, avatars, incarnations, masters, all of them go on insisting and repeating that life is bliss. This is one side, enlightened beings. The other side, the ordinary people, even though they have wealth and everything, they go on insisting life is suffering. See the complete contrast. One side, these guys beaten, abused, arrested, crucified, poisoned, driven from village to village, stoned, what not. I can give you the huge list. All possible things are done. But these guys are going on telling life is bliss, life is bliss. How much ever these guys are abused, they go on insisting that life is bliss. And how much ever wealth and health and everything is created for these guys, the other side, they go on insisting life is suffering. See, whether they understand the reason or not, they all understand this fellow is some way extraordinary. He has something which we don't have. So it is too much to tolerate that somebody has something which we don't have. Whether it is a money, our name, our people, whatever. Whatever this, the people, the unenlightened part of society, feels as essence of life, for what they sacrifice their life, they never get it. Even if they get it, they know they paid and got. So whatever these guys are running after, they are not able to get it. But these guys are just sitting in one place and everything is happening around the world. Everything, the whole world is happening around them. There are only two kinds of people in the world. They go on, try to make happenings around the world, one group. The whole world's happenings happens around them. So one world. Only these two categories. One group insists the life is bliss. By very nature, man is bliss. The other group says, no, 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 life is suffering. What to do? And unfortunately, this group is 0.1%. And this group is 99.999999. There's a very beautiful story of a Sufi mystic, a great enlightened Sufi mystic. He was in a village, spending his time happily teaching or initiating people, helping people to become enlightened. Suddenly one day one angel appeared in front of him and said, you see, by tomorrow morning somebody is going to mix kind of a poison into the village well. Everybody will become mad. So you save a little water for yourself, so you don't become mad. This guy said, no, 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 I have to tell the whole village that not to drink that water. They will become mad. Angel said, don't try that. They will not believe you. They will harm you. He said, but I cannot, just keep quiet. But angel said, this is my advice. After that, up to you. Disappeared. But anyhow, this guy is little intelligent, so he saved little water for himself. Because to tell the villagers, you guys will become mad, he need to protect himself. He saved himself. Next day morning, he said, see, somebody has mixed certain poison. If you drink this water, you'll become mad. Don't drink. He insisted. But as usual, that village leader said, this fellow is little crazy, one nut loose. Somehow we were giving food and shelter for him because he was keeping quiet. And now he is interfering in our administration. Just keep him aside. They pushed him aside. They tried to beat him. Anyhow, they pushed him. All the village drank the water as usual. The whole village became mad. And the most funny thing is, after the whole village became mad, those fellows were not even able to understand they became mad, because the whole village is mad now. Only this one guy is left. So all of them thought this guy has become mad, this Sufi mystic. And they insisted that this guy should be beaten and killed. We can't tolerate him. He should not live in this village. They were about to kill him. The mystic said, just wait, wait, wait for a moment. They asked, what for? Why should we wait? No, I'll become all right. I'll lose my madness. You may think, how? He's not mad. He's okay. Why should he? He said, no, wait. I'll lose my madness. He ran, closed his eyes and drank that water. And the story says, he also became mad and the whole village was comfortable with him. But unfortunately, of course, it's a story. Unfortunately, an enlightened mystic cannot drink that water. Even if he drinks that water, he cannot become mad. Not unfortunately, fortunately. Fortunately, still we have few people left on the planet Earth. As an example, to remind people, life is bliss.